With all the new CPUs and GPUs just about to launch this fall, or in the case of Ryzen 7000 already have launched. But with a new PC comes questions about storage. So what are the good options? So many of you who are about to embark on this journey, the journey this video is about to take you on, are probably getting really excited about either jumping into a brand new build or potentially upgrading an existing older one, or maybe you're just looking to upgrade, you know, just anything in general. However, in the world of storage, there are a lot of options. I mean, a plethora, more so than it seems like in many other components. So what do you do? Well, thanks to the folks at WD Black and Newegg who sponsored this video, I hope we might be able to make the choice just a little bit easier for you. So today I'm gonna walk you through some different products from WD Black that fit a variety of budget points, and in each case should cover all of your storage needs. That way, when you do finally pull the trigger on your brand new PC upgrade, or you go ham on a biscuit on a brand new full-blown PC, you feel as good about your storage when it comes to NVMe drives or possible external solution as you do about the other parts you took so much love and care to place inside of your new gaming rig. Now, before I go too far, it's time for a little bit of education. See, PCIe Gen 4 is the latest standard introduced in 2017 and made its first introduction into the world of PC DIY and PC building with the release of Ryzen 5000 series and X570 and B550 motherboards. Yes, yes, I know about Gen 5. I'm talking about for Gen 4 NVMEs, because people's gonna be like, wait, Gen 5 is actually the latest. Yeah, I get it, but we don't have Gen 5 drives. PCIe Gen 4 has a data transfer rate of 16 gigatransfers or 2 gigabits per second per PCIe lane, which we'll explain in here in just a little bit, versus the literally half as fast PCIe Gen 3 at 8 gigatransfer per second or 1 lowly gigabyte per second per PCIe lane. Now, with the release of 12th gen, we now have the new PCIe Gen 5, and it has a data transfer rate of 32 gigatransfers per second. But right now, games, which is kind of our focus here, can barely, really honestly, take advantage of PCIe Gen 4. Now, essentially, we're gonna talk to you about some of the benefits of Gen 4 NVMe drives. And for the most part, people focus on one thing, and that's storage. You know, look at how fast I can get to my storage. Yes, Gen 4 NVMe drives give you faster access to storage. But there's more to it than that. There's things such as direct storage from Microsoft or new technologies from Intel, AMD, and Nvidia, as well as Sony, that can not only affect how and where a game stores things, but can also improve the amount of FPS you can get in a game. It's like the holy grail for all of these storage companies who are like, yes, it's more than just load times. The hidden benefit is also the amount of data transfer you get in a lane, which in the case of Gen 4 NVMe SSDs, it can actually use half of the amount of PCIe lanes as Gen 3 NVMe SSDs and get the same data transfer rate. See, the best illustration of this is like your CPU is kind of like a freeway system. And that freeway system is made up of PCIe lanes, just like lanes of traffic. So you can think of it as like all lanes that lead to the CPU. Now, everything you put into a PC uses some of these lanes. So it can talk to like the hard drive. And depending on the power needed for that particular component, it can take up more lanes, like 16 for a graphics card, etc. Now, I don't want to take up too much time here on the subject, but the thing is that you need to know is that most people probably don't understand. And in fact, there are like whole maps in motherboard manuals to kind of help you explain this. But even if you have all of the room in the world inside of your case and all of the plugins for your on your motherboard, and you want to put like 50 NVMe SSDs, and you want to throw like 2 graphics cards in there, and then like a capture card, just because you have everything plugged into it, your CPU and the lanes that it's available to doesn't mean that all of that hardware, just because it's plugged in, is going to work at peak efficiency or even at the speed that it's registered to. And there's sometimes it's really hard to know that. And the reason is that these lanes are finite resources. And as you plug in more and more stuff, the PC and the CPU are actually starting to reduce bandwidth and the amount of lanes available to different things, so that way they can turn on more components that you've plugged into the PC. Now, before I go into the products, I do want to make sure that you have the hardware necessary if you aren't upgrading, and you might be curious if maybe one of these drives will work on your existing system, because they may need to. So to use PCIe Gen 4, you either need to be using Ryzen 3000 or 5000 series minus the G series or APUs from Ryzen, so like your 5000G, etc., and have at least an X570 or B550 motherboard or newer for your Ryzen 7000 folks. You can have a newer, like an X670, etc. Now on the Intel side, you need to be running 11th gen or 12th gen Intel. It does work on a Z690, Z590 for sure, or Z690, or newer motherboard like the Z790 that's just now coming out. Obviously, the older you get, the more sketchy this can get, but I wanted to at least call this out if you're gonna look to make the jump to one of these drives, except for our external drive here in the guide. So let's start off with my favorite NVMe drive. In fact, if you look at most of my commission builds, meaning the ones that I have chosen all the parts for, you will see this particular drive and its older predecessor inside of it all the time. And that is the WD Black SN770 PCIe Gen 4 NVMe SSD. Why do I like these so much? I mean, like, what is it about the Gen 4 SN770 that makes me excited? Because they're Gen 4, that means that they are fast, but it also means they're fast enough to be great for gaming, but not so fast that you're paying a lot of extra for what, in many cases, you really don't need. Now, Roby, how fast is it? Because, I mean, that feels like you're caveating it a bit. Well, trust me, it's still fast. We're talking 5150 megabytes per second fast. And by the way, that's only on the 1 terabyte and 2 terabyte models. Now, here is the SN770 500 gig model. And you can see that it's actually $54.99. But the more important thing is look at the max sequential read, which is only at up to 5000 megabytes per second versus the faster, larger 1 terabyte and even 2 terabyte models. To be honest, this is one of my recommendations, and that is forget about the smaller NVMe drives, 500 gigs, etc., because they have a tendency to be slower, and the better value is actually in the larger drives that are not only faster, but you can double the storage capacity for less than half the cost. And plus, the more you fill up the NVMe drive, you are actually starting to fall off in performance. It does happen, so if you give yourself more room, you're gonna have less of that issue. Now, the question is, I say that it's that fast, but do you actually get that speed? Well, the tools that WD uses to see what those speeds are, and there's more than just this, but the one that kind of everybody talks about is a thing called Crystal Disk Mark. And you can see from our benchmarks here that yes, you do in fact see these speeds or in excess of those speeds with the which WD Black is at for advertising. But the more important one is these like real world mix, which you can see right here, that shows that across the board, we're seeing great numbers, which are easily translated into meaning things like your operating system will feel super snappy, your games will load fast, and lastly, large file copies are gonna be nicer and quicker. You know, this isn't gonna be sexy like faster frames, which can actually happen in certain games. You know, like Fortnite, etc., you can see bigger impacts depending on how they do streaming, etc., but it can be very game dependent, and it's really hard to show that stuff. In a lot of ways, it kind of reminds me of a soundtrack of a movie. See, like if your storage is good and everything is running well and you've got the right thing paired with it, then you know what? It's like it makes the experience good and it feels immersive and you never even notice that it's really there. But if it sucks or if it's terrible, then it sticks out and it ruins everything. Now there's a couple things also worth noting with the SN770 before moving on. And the first up is the warranty, which in this case is 5 years. That's a good amount of time and gives you an indication in terms of what Western Digital believes in the product and given the length of time. They also provide a tool called the WD Black Dashboard. And this allows you to do things like monitor your drive health and numerous other bits of functionality. Okay, next up on our list, something else. It's not completely different. I kind of feel like I almost did the now for something. Something completely different. But we have the fast and blazing fast brand new SN850X. See, this is the most recent release from WD, and this one is coming in at 7300 megabytes per second, which is absolutely crazy fast. Is it really that fast, Roby? That's the question. Well, you know what? Let's look at Crystal Disk Mark. You can see that we never hit the full 7300 like we did actually hit that max number of 5150 with the SN770, but we are still hitting almost 7000 on the most optimal test here for showing speeds across the board. But even more telling, just to compare it against its little brother, the SN770, is that the real world mix test shows significant uplift across the board against the SN770 and that we were discussing a little bit earlier. So it is actually fast. But Roby, the question is, where does that speed actually help me? And to be honest, on the PC side for gaming, it's not gonna be To be honest, not that much of a boost, outside of maybe moving larger game files and libraries and drives, etc. But to be clear, the SN770 at 1TB at $99 will more than take care of your PC gaming and Windows operating system's needs. So there are two reasons that this is becoming a more viable option, why you might want to go with an SN850X. And one of those is for content creators who are also gamers, like streamers and YouTubers like myself, and gamers who are also into like media creation. So for instance, somebody who's a video editor who's also into gaming. But don't worry guys, it's not all out for games, because Microsoft has recently released what is called the Direct Storage API. And this is where these even faster, like super fast drives like the SN850X are really gonna shine. What this means is that your GPU, when gaming, can directly load data off of your NVMe SSD and not be bottlenecked by, as weird as it sounds, your very slow kind of process with the CPU. Now, all of the 13th gen and 7000 series adopters are picketing at me right now, because you're like, what are you saying, slow CPU? Just hear me out.
Back when we used to game on our old X286.
No, I'm just kidding. Games were simpler. I mean, not a whole lot, but they were pretty simple. And whole levels could be loaded in one time. And it didn't matter so much, because all that really mattered was how fast you loaded the level. And the level could be basically essentially stored in memory. But now, with worlds being so much bigger and everything not fitting into memory like it used to, developers are doing what are called streaming assets. Now, the way that this works is that the first, your NVMe SSD has to send that data to your CPU, which then does decompression and loads it all out. Then it loads it into memory, and then it can be accessed by your GPU. But with Microsoft's Direct Storage, you can now directly write data between the GPU and the CPU and skip all of that traffic. It's like getting a Jetsons flying car for your textures and your assets. Now, there's still a lot to be proven here, like decompressing the files and all that sort of stuff. But the point is that even with things like that, plus like RTX IO from NVIDIA, and how fast, like basically how much bandwidth we have in Gen 4, that we can push big textures back and forth, have them decompressed, etc., and then bring up those games and everything at very fast speeds. And that's gonna be very handy, and not only will it affect load times, but it'll also affect frame rates, which that's where the SN850X is gonna be awesome. The one other thing worth noting about the 850X is that it's also compatible with the PlayStation 5. You're like, Roby, PlayStation, but it's worth noting. And there is a version with and without a heatsink, so if you wanna upgrade the storage capability and plop one of those fast 2TB drives and not only unlock more storage, but also take advantage of the similar technology to direct storage that PlayStation has, and that's why it's requiring NVMe drives of 5,500 megabytes or faster. Go look at that Unreal demo for the PlayStation 5 that they did. It's just proof of how much drives like this can eventually have the same impact on performance that they are having currently on our console brethren. By the way, you can pick up one of these bad boys from Newegg without a heatsink and 1TB for $159.99, 2TB for $289.99. Now there is a massive 4TB version, but it wasn't available direct from Newegg, but you can pick it up direct from Western Digital for $494.99. Now for the heatsink version, then that's gonna be $173.85 for the 1TB and $309.99 for the 2TB. Now the 4TB isn't compatible with the PlayStation 5, so I'm not gonna bother listing that here. I feel like I got a solid kind of budget-friendly option for like my NVMe SSD and a more robust and potentially game-changing option as well. But what if there was like, what if I wanted to like take my data or my gaming on the go? Is there an option to still have it fast and not so big? It feels like I'm really kind of pushing this here, but the WD has got you covered right here, and that's with the WD Black P40 Game Drive SSD. Which, I mean, let's start with the fact that this has some super awesome RGB lighting that comes with the external portable SSD, and RGB definitely makes data load faster, right? Okay, maybe not, but it does look cool. How fast is it really? I mean, you said it's a gaming SSD. Well, thanks to the power of USB 3.2 Gen 2 by 2, you can get speeds up to 2000 megabytes per second. Now, the USB 3.2 Gen 2 by 2 is actually important, because this doesn't mean you can just go into any old port and make sure that it works. And this is really important to know. You need to check to see if your motherboard has a compatible connection, but you usually have it on the back of your motherboard with all of your other I/O. Okay, Roby, I thought that external drives were slow. Can you really get 2000 megabytes per second? Well, yes, you can. And here, Here we are, Crystal Disk Mark, connected to USB 3.2 Gen 2 by 2, and you can even see here using the ideal and somewhat unrealistic numbers to show, but you can see that we've got 2,000 in certain circumstances, and that this is, again, this is what companies do to tout it, but even when you look at the real world numbers, you can see that this thing is still impressively fast. So if you're like a content creator, or even a gamer who's going to a local LAN, or a Twitch streamer, needing to have your games and settings if you're gonna go do pod streaming or whatever it was, this is a great solution for things just like that. Now understand, you will get slightly slower load times on your games because as fast as this drive is, it's still limited compared to like the SN770 and even some of the older PCIe Gen 3 drives of yore. But you can totally game off of this drive, and outside of the load times, you should notice no other real performance issues, and the delay should be absolutely minimal. But external speed isn't gonna be cheap. And what you can see here is that it has a very similar price to the much faster SN850X. But you have to like, then if you wanna make that portable, you have to like carry your whole PC and take that around, along with your monitor, and your keyboard, and a mouse, and a generator. I think you kind of get it. So for 500 gigabytes of RGB powered external storage on Newegg, it's gonna be $119.99. For 1 terabyte, it's $179.99. And for 2 terabytes, lastly, $329.99. And you'll get that massive 2 terabytes of on-the-go gaming and freedom. Welp, that was a lot of information. I hope it not only gave you an idea of how WD Black will help you with any of your storage needs, whether that's like a new top-of-the-line Ryzen 9 7950X system with like a 4090 and 4 terabytes of SN850X powered storage ready for direct storage and RTX IO, or like your newly upgraded 13600K system and something a little bit more budget, where you need like maybe an additional SN770 to finally play Modern Warfare 2 in its like bajillion gigabyte glory. And finally, we've got that fast, ultra portable P40 game SSD that lets you game and take your files on the go while also making it match your favorite Apple Band color for that ultimate drip. Probably bothers you that I said drip. Probably bothers me too. But anyway, what do you think? Was this actually helpful? Because even though WD Black and Newegg sponsored this video, I wanna make sure this content is also good for you, so give me your feedback. So what did you think about the 3 drives from WD Black? Is there anything that I covered that interested you? And I'd love to know why. And did you learn anything? Now, let me know all of that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robitech. Did you know we have a live stream channel for special builds and events? In fact, you know, that's where we use the majority of these drives. Then come and check out Robitech Live down in the description below so you can like and subscribe and know when we go live so you don't miss another one of these awesome builds like this. If you have questions about these drives or any other tech-related questions, then check out our amazing Discord server, all over at discord.gg/robitech, filled with other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to share their thoughts and ideas on these very subjects. Are you looking for cheap tech? Maybe you want to know when these drives go on sale. Then check out at Robitech Deals on Twitter, or head on over to robitech.com, where we have our guy Tom scouring the internet for the best deals on all things tech, from PC components to TVs to storage to, you know, you name it. Finally, you can also follow me and my team on the other socials absolutely everywhere at Robitech. Let me know. Anyway, guys, we hope you enjoyed this video and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.